thank God for the kids down the line. Mary was shared us, shared Mary with us at Adams and UE. Man, 35 years, 40 years. You all looking at us now, but we were young and young bucks. Full of life. And but the beauty of it was some people that were a little bit older than us. And as we entered that environment, they had the rules. That's what we knew. They gave us opportunities to grow, but they also, we've raised families together. We have started off in life together. So we saw Mary grow from that young man to really understand what it would be in a man. So that's what we thank God. I won't have to extend, they've already had to extend, but it was a very special time, a very special place, and it impacted us all so that we've never totally lost contact with each other. Though we may have separated and gone to different separate spaces in life, that connection is always there. Marion was a great guy.
Yeah.
He was full of love. I'm almost saying he didn't have anything. Because he was good people. But what I say to the family is this: God bless him to be a part of you. The greatest tribute to any human being or to any person is the essence of life that is left behind after they transition. And as I look at you, Marion has good representation moving forward in the earth. I pray that God will continue to bless you, God will keep you. And I will say this, that Marion spoke of you all the time. He loved you all. Because not just because that's what he had to do, because he just really loved you. But once again, you all are him. He may be gone, but God has blessed his bouquet of roses to represent him in a beautiful life. May God bless you and may God keep you. Individual, I and all the thanks God why would you bless me by putting this gentleman in my life? You know, I wanted to retire to desert. He was non-judgmental, non-critical, and I just, there's no other words I can say to express having freedom in my life. And so I thank you again for allowing me to do this. Again, I could go on and on, but I'm not allowed. So thank you so much. On behalf of the crew on 41st Street, 42nd Street, I will always love you. And I'll say, again, by saying this, as my children would know, he'll be the star of the story. I'll always stay with you. Thank you so much.
I That's the day I met. Now, this is Form 314. When I first saw you, I said, why does she look like Elizabeth? As everyone around this life, I was so serious. I held you with a slight awkwardness. When I went home and told Granny how you looked, she set me down with a slice of cake and said, that lizard is now your responsibility. She explained that I had to protect you at all costs. She said that because you were so small, that somebody big but small was the perfect protector. At that age, I didn't understand what that meant, but I quickly found out. You were small and cried a lot. Mom would work and marry you, well, he treated you like a family. He and I would start watching sports and he would cry. Once we figured out what age he was, guess who had changed me? He said he was still learning and you were young lady. The years went by, your crying changed from a dirty look to that's mine, even this time. We even had a crazy baby obsession that drove me insane. When you started daycare, I quit with one or two things. One, you took no mess, and two, I didn't have to watch you for real this world. I always saw that no matter what you were daddy's girl. From the call scary and saying, daddy, I need a big cookie. And daddy, can I ride stairs to the mall? You can be a person. When I continue to grow, I continue hearing your words, protect your sister. And they would remain. He said one day, we all will leave this earth, and it will only be you and your sister alone. You have to protect her. I remember him calling me in Tennessee and saying, Amber, your sister is sick and I can't make it. I told him at that point, I'm on my way. Even to recently, you getting sick of COVID, he said, Amber, please make sure she's okay. Then came 4 weeks ago. Mary and I were on our dialysis on our normal morning shirt. And he said, I need you to promise me something. I told him, in my sleepy voice, I'm listening. He said, promise me you will always be there for your sister. Make sure she's okay. I said to the response, I already watch out for you, but okay. I never could imagine his word being so much this way. Through the journey, we cried. We had yelled. We had laughed together. The last week he was paying, I told my brother to make sure you had children. I was asked that if I would change my life, I did and said no. Because I might not have gotten married as a father, and definitely could not be a sister. And then sometimes I'm losing it. So I just want to know, you guys, and it's always, all of you. Always be better on the other side. But he was determined. And that's just how he was. He always was so good. Everyone could love him. And he did that on him. Throughout my entire life, my dad showed me unconditional love. He never was impatient with me. And he showed me how to be strong and keep pushing through the times that come. He sacrificed more than I ever know, but still being a loving and attentive father. I will take those many life lessons with me for the rest of my life. I love my dad more than words can say, and he will live in my heart forever. He was a wonderful husband and father, uncle, and friend, and he will be missed.
Thank you.